For his dark and drafty houses, his four-foot living. The end of your accounts must be settled. Cratchit, if a man owes me money, he will settle his accounts, Christmas Eve or not. Time is 7 o'clock, which means if you will allow me to observe it, you are still 2 hours in my debt for the day's work.
Might it be a light, sir? Just as once, to slip out to the toy shop. I thought I might buy something cheap and bright that I saw in the window for my own tin.
Toy shop? But hang your tip, sir, for all I care. 7 o'clock is your time and not a second sooner.
Yes, Mrs. Scrooge.
Christmas Eve, huh? Will Scotland. Your pen, sir, if you please.
Scrooge and Marley sit beside above the door. But Marley was dead. Scrooge never painted out his partner's names, so sometimes people new to the business called Scrooge Scrooge,
and sometimes Marley.
But he answered to both names. It was all the same to him.
The Marley brothers had been dead 7 years. Scrooge had never spent one moment's thought on his dead partners. But tonight, my young shavers, he will have much reason to think of the Marley brothers.
Oh, he was a tight-fisted hand at the grindstone, Scrooge. A squeezing,
rasping,
scraping old sinner, hard and sharp as flint, from which no steel ever struck warming fire. No spring sun could warm, no wintry weather chill him. No one ever stopped Scrooge in the street with a,
"My dear Scrooge, how are you? Will you come see me?"
No beggar asked him for a halfpenny. No children asked him the time of day.
No lost traveller would ask directions of him.
Even the blind man's dog knew him, hurrying his sightless master into the doorway to avoid him.
But all this satisfied Scrooge, for now he could be alone with himself
and his money. Of all the world, only one person still worked for Scrooge's salvation, his nephew Fred.
Fred Scrooge.
My dear, won't take a moment.
But why?
Because he's my uncle. He would be invited by no one else to Christmas dinner, so we must invite him.
Good, if he would come, but he won't come.
Probably not.
He's never come.
True. My dear, it's Christmas. Give me a kiss.
Close your eyes.
Closed.
Tight?
Yes. Merry Christmas, Uncle. God save you.
Hum.
Christmas a hum, Uncle. You don't mean that, I'm sure.
I do. What reason do you have to be merry? You're poor enough.
What reason do you have to be miserable? You're rich enough.
Hold on.
Don't be cross, Uncle.
What else can I be when I live in such a world of fools as this? What's Christmas to you but a time for finding yourself a year older and not an hour richer?
Uncle,
nephew, you keep Christmas in your own way and let me keep it in mine.
Keep it, but you don't keep it.
Let me leave it alone then. Much good may it do you.
Surely, Uncle. A thing can do us good, but that's making money from it. And so I say, bless Christmas.
Let us out from you, sir, and you'll spend your Christmas by losing your situation.
Let me have your clock, Uncle. Come, time is tomorrow.
Soup stuff.
But why? Why?
Why did you get married after I forbid it?
Because I fell in love.
Because you fell. Good afternoon.
I'm sorry with all my heart to find you so resolute, but our invitation is here. And you shall have it. We will lay a place for you as you do every year.
Don't trouble yourself. Good afternoon.
Merry Christmas.
Good afternoon.
And a happy new year.
Good afternoon.
Merry Christmas to you, Bob Cratchit. And to your family.
Same to you, sir. The conference of the season.
Good afternoon.
Merry Christmas to all.
Indeed so.
1, 2, 3, 4. Deck the halls with boughs of holly. Fa la 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 la. Tis the season to be jolly. Fa la 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 la.
You keep your wife and family on 15 shillings a week. And you talk of Merry Christmas, madman.
But Mr. Scrooge.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly.
Sir Adam, I leave it to sport us. Died 7 years ago this very night.
We have no doubt that their generosity is well represented by a surviving partner.
generosity, you say?
Yes, Mr. Scrooge. At this festive season market, it is more than usually desirable that we should provide an poor who suffer greatly in this cold season. Hundreds of thousands are the greatest need in this city.
Are there no prisons?
Plenty of prisons, alas.
Alas.
And the workhouses, are they still in operation?
But my dear sir, these hard institutions offer no comfort for the poor. And so, a few of us are attempting to raise funds to buy the poor some food and drink and means of all. What can I put you down?
Nothing.
You wish to be anonymous?
I wish to be left alone. I do not make myself merry at Christmas, and I can't afford to make idle people merry. Through taxation I help pay for the prisons and workhouses, and that costs me enough. Those who are that badly off must go there.
Many cannot go there, and many would rather die.
Well, if they'd rather die, they'd better do it and decrease the surplus population. But, excuse me, I don't know that.
If you would have come with us through the streets we have walked down tonight, and see the poor, and see the destitute, see through their eyes, passers by laden down by Christmas riches, you would know it then, sir, you would know it then.
It's none of my business. It's enough for a man to understand his own business, let alone interfere in other people's. Good afternoon, ladies. It's none of my business. None of my business. Suppose you'll want all day tomorrow.
It's very convenient, sir.
It's not convenient and it's not fair. If I were to stop you half a crown, would you think yourself ill-used? And yet, you don't think me ill-used when I pay a day's wages for no work.
It's only once a year, sir.
Poor excuse for robbing a man's pocket every 25th of December. I suppose you must have the whole day. Be here all early the next morning.
Yes, Mr. Scrooge. Thank you, Mr. Scrooge. After all, there's only one more sleep till Christmas.
The Marley brothers were dead. Imagine then the emotions of Ebenezer Scrooge when, after having his melancholy supper at his usual melancholy tavern, and after he had had his melancholy supper at his usual melancholy tavern, and after he had read all the free newspapers at that tavern, and passed what remained of the night in studying in his bank book what people still owed him money, imagine his emotions when, standing at the door of his house, the door knocker, which he had seen night and day for many a year, had now not the appearance of a door knocker at all, but that of Jacob Marley's face.
Well!
And not a dead face neither.
And all at once, it was a door knocker again.
Oh. Come on. Something I ate to play with. That cheese didn't agree with me.
Marley's face, or a piece of undigested cheese playing tricks on Scrooge's eyes. He was startled.
Still, I won't believe it.
Scrooge! Ebenezer Scrooge!
Marley, listen. No. I don't believe it, so I won't believe it.
No.
Oh, God, save me!
Seven Christmases ago, tonight,
yours is a heavy chain indeed.
How do you know that?
We have watched you for our sins.
Don't be too hard on me, brothers.
Comfort you may get, but
that's not from
not
us. In life, we marked our lives together. In life, we kept our lives within the confines of our money-changing hole. Yet our spirits never looked beyond it. But now we are condemned to travel. An eternal journey.
You mean you've traveled in this direction for 7 years?
No rest, no peace, endless sorrow.
Do you travel fast?
On the wings, on the wings! But always within the bounds of these chains.
You're always good men of business, brothers.
Business? Mankind was our business. We're good for our business.
To think we walked amongst our fellow creatures with our eyes cast downwards. If but our eyes had been looked to see the misery that was around us, that was within our power to remove. But these eyes, like yours, Scrooge, saw nothing.
No, don't be too hard on me, brothers.
We came here tonight to warn you that you are yet a chance of escaping our fate.
You're always good friends to me, brothers, thank you.
You will be haunted by 3 ghosts.
That is a hope you mentioned.
Yes.
No, like, soon or not.
If you are to avoid the travel, the road that we travel, you will be invited to listen to the ghosts. The first will call upon you at the stroke of 12 tonight. The second on the next night at the same hour.
Can't I just take them all at once and have it over with?
Expect a bird on the next when the last stroke of 12 cease to vibrate.
But I don't want to be visited.
Ebenezer! Come to the window and see for a moment with our eyes and tell us what you see, man.
Oh,
what do you see?
The night is full of phantoms. All chained as you are. And him. Him in my life, I knew him.
Which?
Him there. That ghost all bound with the chains, safes and heavy bankbooks. We did business together. And there, that poor wretch, is that his fate forever from us?
It is his and ours. What do you see, Ebenezer?
I see a woman. A poor wretched woman and a child. Huddled to the doorway. There's a rat cake round against the chilling snow. The ghost reaches out to help, but his chains hold him back. Is this how you spent the past 7 years, brothers? Oh, dreadful punishment, brothers. Brothers? Can't be. It was past 2 when I went to bed. The clock must be wrong. Lord, clock's correct. Why, it isn't possible. Could I have slept through a whole day and far into another night? Or is it possible that something's happened to the sun and it's 12 at noon? Don't be a damn fool, Scrooge. Not a sound. Pitch black, streets deserted. Oh, God, I've lost today. Clock strikes 12. Oh! It's a bad dream. Perhaps it's a bad dream. Expect the first. first... Well, there are no spirits here. Proves it was a cheat. Keep away, I'm asleep. Spirit whose coming was foretold to you.
I am.
Who and what are you?
I am the ghost of Christmas
past. Long past?
Your past.
Spirit, you look, if I may say so, somewhat worn.
I am the ghost of your past Christmas, Spirit. You made me that.
I am sorry, but what business brings you here? If you cared about my welfare, you'd go and leave me to sleep.
No, I seek your explanations. Come, rise.
No, Spirit, no. The weather is hard and I have a cold. It will be gone in a day or so. Return then, good Spirit. But meanwhile, leave me to sleep. I know this place. My father sent me to school here, God, how many years ago? There's the road to school, and the old stile's still there. There's the conker tree, the conkers we got from that tree. I got Hansel and Tanner from that very tree. How do I remember that? Certainly not. It is my cold. I believe I mentioned I had a cold. Lead on, Spirit.
You remember the way?
Remember it? I could walk it blindfolded.
Strange, you've forgotten so many years.
Spirit, There's the bridge by the school. Those boys on ponies there. It's Jack, the small one. Jack, what's his name? And the farmer's boy. What a catapult he has. Spirit, when all the other children went home for the Christmas holidays and I could not, they asked me to play with them, the village boys. There's Wilhelmina, the village dog, who had her puppies in the school on Christmas Eve. Wilhelmina, here, girl. I stole milk for those puppies, Spirit. Jack, Charlie, it's me, Ebenezer. Spirit, they do not answer me. Wilhelmina. Oh, do but look at the Christmas parade. Every car for miles used to gather in the empty school every Christmas Eve. There's Jenny and Albert. I sat by her on the cart one year. For a moment. But still, for a moment. And Albert, the fattest boy in the village, the human donut. And there's the twins. Do you not think this child is quite alone? Poor boy. Poor by your wish. But it's too late now.
What's the matter?
Nothing. Nothing. There were just some carol singers at my door last night. I should have liked to have given them something, that's all.
Let us see another Christmas. The boy still wanders the empty school. Every day.
May.
Never a strong girl.
No.
A delicate creature whom a breath might have withered, but she had a strong heart.
Well, she had. She had.
She died too in childbirth and had, I think.
No. No more spirit.
Your nephew, Fred.
No more spirit, no more! How many years do we travel? And to where?
Look down, Scrooge. Surely it's known to you.
Where are we?
Here is the warehouse door.
There we are. With... Oh.
Yeezy, we must have you. Where are those idle fiddlers?
Mr. Fezziwig. No, it's Spirit. I was apprenticed here. Such wonderful people.
Come, sirs. This will all your fingers and your throat. My apprentices are dads, I assure you.
Dick, Ebenezer! Come, lads, no more work for us, eh, Dad?
Indeed not. Christmas Eve, my dandies. Christmas Eve. All work.
And no play.
Makes Jack a dull boy. Come, lads, let's put these shutters up where you can say Jack Robinson. The muses going to waste.
Oh, wonderful. Sheep. There. The girl from the warehouse across the road. Stephen's never held a Christmas party there. Mr. Fezziwig insisted she came to us.
Thank you.
Christmas. Merry Christmas, and all my hearty thanks for the work you have done this year. I close my speech.
Small matter to make this silly post so full of gratitude.
Small? Mr. Fezziwig!
Mr. Fezziwig!
Why, is it not? He has spent but a few pounds of your mortal money. £3 or £4 perhaps. Is that so much that he deserves all of his praise?
It isn't that. It's just Mr. Fezziwig had the power to make us happy or unhappy. He chose to make us happy, and the happiness he gave us is quite as great as if it cost a fortune.
Come, the buffet is laid in the office. Eat your fill. Well, then Punch and Judy come at 7.
No, mercy, good spirit, mercy!
Your own London office is now, Scrooge. Your fiancé, the same lovely girl.
Spare me this. Spare me this!
Why'd you say I've changed? I've not. At least, I've not changed towards you.
Once he told me that Mr. Fezziwig was the most kind employer you'd ever had. Then he'd taken you to the model and everything.
Fezziwig was a fool. Pleasant fool, but fool nonetheless.
Some respect, sir, if you please. Mr. Fezziwig's twice the man you'll ever be.
I've not changed towards you, Belle. Why'd you condemn a man merely because he wished to make himself rich?
Ebenezer, I've seen all your ideals fall away one by one.
I've grown wiser, yes. I've not changed towards you, am I? Am I?
She's leaving you. She's leaving you. She's the only one you ever loved. Last, you turn your face. Look at what you lose. Look. Spirit. Look.
I hope you're happy with the life you've chosen.
Go after her, you young fool. Why don't you? Why don't you? Spirit, show me no more. Why do you delight to torture me?
Why should I do more?
No more. No, I don't want to see it.
Many years passed, the same girl. Now long and happy married, the girl who was so quickly forgotten still had a kind thought of you.
Charlie, what are you doing up with little Charlie? It's way past midnight.
I couldn't help it, Mum. I was putting the stockings at the foot of the bed. She runs up, still asleep, and grabs a beard if you please. Strong do you know, wouldn't give way. I cried out, he woke up. Straight away asked why Father Christmas had taken so long to get from the North Pole to Hackney Way. Most indignant that I had arrived before he fell asleep.
But what did you say?
Told little Charlie at the Christmas elves in Greenland had given me some snow reindeers this year.
Oh, Merry Christmas, Charlie.
Merry Christmas, Belle.
Spirit, take me away from here, please.
Belle, I saw an old friend of yours this afternoon.
Who?
Mr. Scrooge. I passed his office window. His partner Marley lies upon the point of death, I hear.
Spirit, remove me from this place.
I told you, these are the shadows of things that have been. They are what they are. Do not blame me.
Remove me, I cannot bear it. I cannot bear it. Haunt me no longer, Spirit. Leave me to sleep. Haunt me no longer, please. On the second act. That's what the Marley brothers said. All right, come on, whoever you are. You won't take me by surprise this time. There. Not coming.
Ebenezer Scrooge, I am the ghost of Christmas present. Look upon me. Look upon me.
Spirit, leave me be. I cannot endure such another night as your fellow spirit offered me. The past is past. I cannot change it. And I cannot change. So please, Spirit, leave me to sleep.
Thank you.
heard it, but I've forgotten the words.
Scrooge, is this how you treat your Christmas guests? Come, man, have you no festive fare to offer?
I regret not, Spirit. I do not make myself merry at Christmas.
What? No flask about, you know, mince pies, no Christmas cake, wine?
I regret not, Spirit.
Scrooge, Scrooge, we have a long day before us. We must see all that this great day offers, every sight, but we cannot begin it without something to fortify us. Come, man, will you join me in making merry?
I do not know how.
Then I will teach you, man. Come, as woman's pies in that direction.
Spirit!
And now, my young friends, we're going to follow the good ghost's festive example and refresh ourselves. Perhaps you'd care to do the same. Sweet meats
down there, Spirit. The parade of carolers is this Christmas morning.
Regiment, Tim?
Two regiments and the Navy, too.
There. And the pudding. Will it go round?
And round and round till we burn.
It's a very small pudding.
A toast. Merry Christmas and God bless us all.
God bless us, everyone. Life is full of sweet surprises.
Tell me Tiny Tim will live.
I see a vacant seat in the chimney corner and a crutch without an owner, carefully preserved in memory. If these shadows are being allotted by the future, the child will die.
No, kind spirit, say he'll be spared.
If these shadows remain unaltered by the future, none of my kind will find him here.
No!
What then, if you'd like to die, you'd better do it and decrease the surplus population.
No!
Man, if man you be in heart, do you know what the surplus is and where it is? Do you decide what man shall live and what man shall die? It's no fit to inside of heaven, you are worthless, and less fit to live than millions more, like this poor man's child.
Mr. Scrooge, I give you Mr. Scrooge, the founder of the feast.
The founder of the feast indeed! I wish I had him here. I'd give him a piece of my mind to feast upon. I hope he'd have a good appetite for it.
My dear, the children, Christmas Day!
It should be Christmas Day, I'm sure. On which day one drinks the health of such an odious, stingy, hard and appealing man as Mr. Scrooge. You know he is, Bob. Nobody knows it better than you, poor fellow.
My dear, Christmas Day.
I'll drink his health for your sake and for the day's, but not for his. A long life to him, a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. You'll be very merry and very happy, I have no doubt.
Come, Tim. I've seen some children have made a handsome sigh down in the corner. Let's go have a shoot down at night before dinner. What do you say?
Yes, Father.
There was a pig when I had to dig, Christmas Day, Christmas Day. There was a pig when I had to dig, Christmas Day in the morning.
Come. We
still
have much to see
in little time. Spirit, I'm ready. He said that Christmas was a humbug. As I live, he believed it too.
More shame with him, Fred.
Shame.
No, he's a common glove, fellow. I couldn't be angry with him if I tried. Who suffers by his whims? Him always. He takes it into his head to dislike us. And he won't come and dine with us. But what's the consequence? He don't lose much of a dinner.
What sort of dinner does he lose?
A good one, my dear.
Not good.
Excellent.
Not excellent, superb.
Thank you.
In any event, I mean to give him the same chance to come to dinner here, whether he likes it or not.
Fred, if your uncle were to come here tonight upon your invitation, I would put a 10 and skip the floor. I would.
No, you're too hard. I'll try again next year.
Thank you, Fred. Thank you kindly.
Now then, let's play a game.
Yes, yes.
What will it be?
Scrooge.
A few moments, Spirit.
Yes and no.
Agreed.
Very well. Yes and no is it. Now, I'm thinking of something. You may question me, but I may only answer yes or no.
A pancake. St. Paul's Cathedral. A Christmas pudding. An African giraffe.
Is it in this room?
No.
Is it in London?
Yes.
Still could be the giraffe. The one in the zoo.
Is it a street? Is it this street?
No and no.
A district?
No.
No, no, no. You're on the wrong track, nitwits.
Is it alive?
Yes.
I knew it. It's a giraffe. Fred always loved giraffes.
Is it an animal?
Yes.
Is it a wild animal?
Yes.
Is it a boar? Ape? Bear?
No, no, no. You're on the wrong track.
This is not a friendly animal.
No. Pleasant.
It's a giraffe, an African giraffe. Why don't you listen?
I have it, Fred. I have it. It's your favourite. An African giraffe.
Alas, has brains, this one.
No.
A wild animal, an unpleasant animal, lives in London, is not led around on a chain. A human animal.
Yes.
A human animal that talks.
Yes. Occasionally, I should say.
And roams around London uncaged.
Yes.
I have it, Fred.
Then what is it?
It's your Uncle Scrooge, correct?
It is, I confess it.
Well then, Fred, I must protest.
Thank you. On what score?
On two scores, Frederick. Your attitude, is it a bear, was no. And your attitude, is it a boar, was no. Well, I call that stretching the truth.
Well, boar or not, he's given us plenty of merriment, I'm sure. So let's go in, drink yourself, and then we dance. We'll wish the old man a Merry Christmas wherever he is. You won't take it from me, but it'll take from all of us nonetheless. Uncle Scrooge.
To Uncle Scrooge.
My life upon this globe is very brief. It ends tonight.
Tonight?
Tonight at midnight.
Spirit. Forgive me if I'm not justified in what I ask, but two children are in the boy clinging to you. Are these little ones yours?
They are man's, but they cling to me. The boy's ignorance and the girl is lead. Never again turn your back on our existence, Scrooge. Not on this boy ignorance, nor on this girl needs.
Will nobody help you in your good work? Will nobody take them in?
Are there no prisons? Are there no workhouses?
Are there no prisons?
Are there no workhouses?
Are there no prisons?
Are there no workhouses?
In the presence of Christmas yet to come.
Bye. won't. He's past missing anything. Get me? Here. It's from that old man came for once a month. There. See my point? Anyone who's mean enough to part with him more once a month don't deserve better. You agree? Wake up. These blankets have still got some wear in them. These sheets are a bit, but they'll wash up with plenty of bleach. Now, these bed curtains are good. The ring's worth 5 bob, I know.
Miss Max, you didn't.
What?
Didn't take these bed curtains out with dead body still lying there, did you?
Well, he hadn't been fetched.
And yourself still lying in these sheets?
Yes.
Blimey, you've got some face.
I agree, by the rest of it. But look at this nightshirt. This is the best nightshirt. It'd be wasted if it hadn't been for me.
And you mean?
Some fool putting it in it to be buried? Well, I had that off him. None of that.
Well, I'll say this for you, Miss Mags. You've got some face. You'll have to come down to the shop for a second price on this collection. I need a second opinion. It didn't die of disease, did he?
Nah, not him. No self-respecting disease would have gone near him. He just outlived his welcome. Good riddance, the old miser.
I fear the case of this unhappy man might have been my own. My life tends to be that way now. No, Spirit. This graveyard is a fearful place, and I have learnt my lesson. Trust me.
Father walks so slower than he used to. But I've known him all the time to look at the shadows very fast indeed.
You dear, have me friend again.
Spirit, are these the shadows of things that will be? Or the things that may be only? Spirit, hear me. I'm not the man I was. I'm not the man I would have been without you and your fellow spirits. The Marley brothers offered me hope, but you. You appear to offer me none. Why show me this if I am beyond all hope? Show me I may live in hope. I see you, Peter. I see it. Promise me I may change these shadows by an altered life. I will honour Christmas in my heart and try to keep it all year round. I will live in the past, present and the future. The spirits of all three will live inside me. I will not shut out the lessons you've taught me. Show me I may live in hope. Show me I may live in hope. Show me I may live in hope.
Thank you.
of spirit. Spirit, I do live in hope. I will live in the past, present, and the future. Oh, heaven, spirits, and the Mali brothers be praised for this. I say it on my knees. The blankets, still here. She didn't steal them. They're here. I am here. The shadows of things that could have been can be dispelled. They will be. Yes. Yes, they will be. I know it. I know it. I don't know what to do. I'm light as a feather. Take a cab, of course, and there'll be 5 shillings in it for yourself. So, what do you say? Will you run me this errand?
5 shillings? Run it. You watch me.
I'll send it to Bob Cratchit. He shall know he sent it. It's twice the size of Tiny Tim. I'm going... Well, not in this. Oh, heck, I'll go in this. With a thankful heart, with an endless story, with a growing family, every girl and boy will be nephew and niece to me. Da-da-da. Da 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 da, we belong, hope and peace to me. La ba da 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 da, yes, and every night will end, and every day will start with a grateful prayer and a thankful heart. Life is like a journey, who knows where it ends? And if you need to know the measure of a man, you simply count his friends. Stop and look around you. The glory that you see is born again each day. Don't let it slip away. How precious life can be. With a thankful heart that is wide awake, God, you make this promise. Every breath I take will be used now to sing your praise. La 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 la, to beg you to share my days. Da 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 da, with a loving guarantee that even if we part, I will hold you close in a thankful heart, in a thankful heart. Please, stop and thank you. I trust you gathered a great deal of money for the poor last night. A Merry Christmas, ladies, a very Merry Christmas.
Mr. Scrooge?
Yes, yes, that is my name, and I fear it may not be pleasant to you. Allow me to ask your pardon, and will you have the goodness to accept the sum of?
Mr. Scrooge? Mr. Scrooge?
Not a penny less, not a penny less, my ladies. Since our last meeting, I have walked down those streets that you talked of. And you can expect further back payments to support that. So, ladies, will you come and see me?
Lord bless us, Mr. Scrooge. Are you serious? Well, I honestly don't know what to say.
Say nothing. Say nothing. Just come and see me, ladies. Come and see me.
We will.
Thank you 50 times. I am very much obliged.
And that was the beginning of the most wonderful day Scrooge had ever spent. Wonderful party, wonderful games, wonderful happiness.
He had one more thing to do. He daren't sleep that night as he had to be in the office very early the next morning. If only he could get there first and catch Bob Cratchit coming in late. That he had his heart set upon.
Bah! Bah! Bah!
The clock struck 9 o'clock. No Bob. 9:15 and still no Bob. It was a full 9:18 when...
By what means do you come here at this time of day, sir?
I am sorry. I'm behind in my time, sir.
Yes. Yes, I think you are, yes. Yes, stand down, sir, if you please.
I'm sorry, sir. It will not be repeated again. I was making rather merry yesterday, Mr. Scrooge.
No, it shan't be repeated. No. No, I'm not going to stand for this sort of thing any longer. No. I'm not. And therefore, I'm going to raise your salary.
But you just wait there, Mr. Scrooge. Don't excite yourself. Hello! Please!
No, not at all, Bob Cratchit, not at all. A Merry Christmas! A Merrier Christmas than I have given you in a long year.
Oh, after you, Mr. Scrooge.
By no means, after you, Mr. Cratchit.
And Scrooge was better than his word. He did it all, and infinitely more. And to Tiny Tim, who did not die, he was a second father.
He became as good as a man as a good old city had ever seen. And it was always said of him that he knew how to keep Christmas, if any man alive possessed the knowledge. May it be truly said of us, and, as Tiny Tim observed,
God bless us, everyone.
Well, I met someone who touched my soul and made my world brand new. There's a part of me, a place inside that now belongs to you. The love we found, we carry with us, so we're never quite alone. The love we found, the sweetest dream that we had ever known. The love we found, we carry with us, so we're never quite alone.
It feels like Christmas.
excellent production, fantastic production. Well done, all of you. I feel very proud to be standing here tonight as head teacher of Llanidloes High School, because we've just witnessed a fantastic array of talent, both in acting and in singing terms. And it really was, I think, a community production in every sense of the word, in the sense that we've had pupils taking part, we've had members of staff taking part. I have been referred to as Scrooge myself, because it's been known for me to get them to work for every single penny that they earn. And that means taking part in evening productions as well. So, as I say, it's been a really, truly community production tonight. I've got to make thanks, and I want to make thanks, but I don't want to forget anybody, so please bear with me. Mrs. Griffiths, where's Mrs. Griffiths? Is she around? Mrs. Griffiths, come down, please. Up in the back there. I know she didn't want to be in the spotlight, but if it wasn't for the efforts of Mrs. Griffiths, I can assure you this production wouldn't have gone ahead. Also, similarly, Mrs. Board on the musical side of things. Mrs. Board there. Fantastic effort with the music there. At the back, we've got the staging and lighting crew, who I believe are Ellie Adams, Bronwen Moses, and Ben Johnson Rolfe. The technical team, can we give them a big hand? The school brass band at the back there have worked hard. As I've mentioned, members of staff. Also at the back there, we've got, talking of the ghost of Christmas past, we've got a pupil from the past, an ex-sixth former, Sophie King, who's been working conscientiously at the piano all evening. Sophie. Okay, and also, look at this, so I don't fix it. The art department, of course, for the excellent scenery that we had. The PTA, who've been working extremely hard at the back there in terms of refreshments on both evenings, last night and tonight, and they've done an excellent job. We thank you very, very much. Your contribution to the school is very much appreciated. And finally, I'd like to thank you, the audience, for attending. Obviously, without an audience, we don't really have a production. It's nice to see so many of you here tonight, and last night was full. Thank you very much. I think we've got most of the town council here tonight as well. So thank you very much for coming tonight. It isn't quite all over, because I persuaded Mrs. Griffiths and Mrs. Board to put another production on tomorrow, another performance in the morning, for Ray at a primary school. And there's about 100 of them coming up from Rayada, so I'm sure it'll be another successful performance again tomorrow. So once again, thank you all for your efforts. It's been a fantastic night, and we hope to see many, many more. Thank you very much. Were feeling Christmassy before tonight, I'm sure that you feel a little bit more Christmassy after tonight. So I think it's not too early to say have a Merry Christmas to you and a Happy New Year.